Good evening. Lovely to see you all here. My apologies. This is really my fault. The program across the street was An American in Paris, but I don't play any Gershwin, so we had to settle for A Frenchman in New York. Sorry about that. But it's also it's you can't really call it a celebration, but it is the 100th anniversary of the death of Debussy. So it's a remembrance, and it's always good to have an excuse to play this incredible music. So, and now I get to introduce my new friends, Friedrich and Philippe, who will come and play these amazing gadgets. So, I know that these instruments. Well, first of all, they're quite. I've never seen. There's no water in any of these, is there?
No.
It's just they're just made to do this, right? And they're different sizes.
You could try to fill them with water, but it would leak.
Oh, I see. They have no bottom. Yeah. That's very, very.
Nice.
Yes, very silly of me. And you have black. You have some black spots here. Are those like the black notes on the piano? Is that sort of the idea?
Yes. So it is chromatically organized, uh-huh, like a piano. Okay. And
do you want to use the mic just in case?
Just in case.
Just in case. Yeah.
Yeah. The tubes are organized in a similar fashion as the piano. Uh-huh. So there are always three chromatic notes behind each other. Okay. And my instrument has a range of 2.5 octaves. And the black dots, they're just as an orientation for us.
Got it.
Otherwise, we would get lost.
Yes, but, I understand that very well.
You're familiar with the concept.
Yeah, I get lost also, yeah. So I have to read something, because I've just met you, and you seem like incredibly nice and wonderful people. And this is a quote from a German musicologist, sort of the time when the instrument became popular in the late 1700s. Gluck used it, Dussek used it, Mozart wrote for it. Now here is someone named Friedrich Röchlitz who says the following: the harmonica excessively stimulates the nerves, plunges the player into a nagging depression, and hence into a dark and melancholy mood that is an apt method for slow self-annihilation. If you are suffering from any kind of nervous disorder, you should not play it. If you're not yet ill, you should not play it. If you're feeling melancholy, you should not play it. What, can you explain this at all? Or is this guy just crazy?
Well, I survived a few years of playing it,
yeah,
so.
You both seem just fine.
Yes, absolutely. I can confirm, and I think Philip is same opinion. After a few, you have to take breaks while you practice. After about, for me, it's like,
10 minutes.
10 minutes for him. I'll get through an hour, but then okay. I have to take a break. Otherwise, it's really, kind of exhausting to listen to it.
Well, I'm going to leave you guys to the Haydn and see you in a bit.
Just some few words to the piece we will play. It's a piece by Joseph Haydn. It's from the collection of the Countess, the Fürstin Ernestine von Menzingen-Geusau. It's shorter, FEVMG, or as her friend called her, Phoebe. She attended the concert where the famous glass harmonica player Marianne Kirchgesner played the harmonica. She was really famous around the time and traveled through a lot of cities. They met in Karlsruhe. And the light went down, and Mrs. Phoebe, she sat in the audience and heard the Haydn. But as she was a countess, of course, she could afford a real glass harmonica. As we are not countesses, so we can't afford a real glass harmonica, so we built the modern version of it, which is, we can explain later, at some point, better and more virtuoso, dynamic, and yeah. But when Mrs. Phoebe, she heard the Haydn, she wanted the music, but the glass harmonica player, Mrs. Kirschgessen, was blind. So she didn't have any music in front of her, it was all learned by memory. So the countess had to use her ergonomic acoustic recording system of her own, her ears. So she wrote it down as good as she could. She missed out some bits, I'm sure. But in the end, she liked it so much. In her own performances, she included a nice, quaint chorale at the end. And the title of the chorale is Thank God. It's over. No. No. Okay. No. No. It's you raise me up, and a slightly different version than Westlife.
Thank you.
now we're doing Piazzolla for something completely different. I have to ask you, I guess I should ask both of you, how do you get through security with these things?
Yeah, well, not with these big difficulties anymore. This is the prototype of the new traveling instrument. That's why I brought screwdrivers, because we transported from Geffen Hall and Kaplan for rehearsals and for concerts. We constantly transported, so something always resonates a bit. I hope I'm sorry for that. but in order to not get thrown out of the airplane anymore, like I did once by EasyJet, we constructed a new instrument which can be taken apart into four parts, and we put the tubes in a big suitcase which sits next to me, so we don't have a problem anymore nowadays.
But you said this is the travel size? Wow.
Well,
amazing.
The bigger size is, well, yeah.
Okay.
And the piece we will play is, it's called Tanti Anni Prima. This actually means so many years ago. I read that it's from a movie with Claudia Cardinale, CC, and they renamed it to actually Ave Maria after some time for commercial reasons, of course. But whatever you prefer, you can imagine.
Thank you.
Because now we have the Mozart piano sonata, just the boring piano. But it's not a boring piece. It's an amazing amazing sonata, I think. Mozart wasn't somebody who really grew up with Bach. He somehow got interested in Bach later in his life, and all of a sudden he started writing counterpoint. So the first movement of this piece is all about counterpoint. It sounds a little bit like a Bach 2 or 3 part invention in parts. And the second movement is absolutely wild harmonically. And the third movement is a rondo that he had written before, and he just thought it would work well with the first two movements. So he figured, why should I spend half an hour on another movement when I could write an opera instead? Anyway, hope you enjoy it. I adore this piece. So.
Thank you.
We do have one encore scheduled. It's also by Mozart. It's called Abend Empfindung an Laura. It's an aria which I think was actually recently done in a Don Giovanni instead of another aria. So it's very nice, a beautiful song. Evening, what is Abend Empfindung is?
Evening, the sense of the evening.
With Laura.
With Laura.
That's nice. Okay.